Hello dear friends, if Sanhya is asked to just talk about anything, he generally has little to say. He responds better to questions and in communicating through dialogue. In that format he does not claim to be speaking truth, but rather to be saying what the questioner needs to hear at that moment. This brings about what appears to be a logical inconsistency in his statements from one moment to another, but that can support the mind in letting go of the illusion of understanding. Sometimes I think that if there is a method to his madness, it is to leave the mind so confused that it simply gives up the ghost. I, likewise, find that as time goes on I have less and less to say. When it comes to these monthly notes to you, I usually begin by not being aware of anything I want to say unless there is logistic information to pass on. Then, Sanhya throws me a bone and I crawl off after it. Thus, knowing becomes gnawing. Michael, I am hearing differing things from you. What is reality? Good, now you know it is both difficult and easy to speak out of both sides of my mouth. It is difficult because I have neither a mouth nor sides, but it is easy because I just place the words in Michael's mouth, and he has agreed to share them without question. Any words that I use do not tell the truth, so it can be helpful to state things in differing and even contrasting ways to approximate truth, to triangulate what actually is. I have been talking differently about reality in some of the more recent messages than I did in messages back several years ago. If you want to check that out for yourself, click here and then click on reality for a list all the messages where the term is mentioned. Anyway, this is a good question, so let's look more deeply into it. Recently we have talked about reality as being what is in the now. For example, if it is raining now, that is the reality. We talk in terms of simple acceptance of what is in the now. If you have resistance to reality, if you want to change it, good luck with that. But it's not just the weather, it's everything. What is. It cannot be changed. You might want to change it in the future, even the near future. That's another matter we will deal with shortly, but reality is what is here right this moment. When one ignores it or doesn't accept it, is upset and in opposition to it, or wants to change it, there will be frustration, pain, suffering, and a sense of failure because the now cannot be altered. The reality cannot be changed. When there is resistance to the now, it makes it nearly impossible to hear your inner guidance, spirit, or your divine self, because the ego mind is just too loud. This is the reality we have been referring to. It has been suggested that the more one is willing to notice what is present right now without judging it or wishing to change it, the more one accepts the feelings triggered in this now, the more one learns to hear that quiet inner voice. We have encouraged you to do that, to take what is in the now as the perfect thing, to receive what Spirit is presenting to you to help you realize your divine nature. Let's start moving out to a wider sense of reality. One step out is to say that your only function for being, for having this experience in the physical with a body, is to wake up to the truth of your divine nature. Nothing else matters. That's a big step from accepting the now. Nothing else matters but being awake. In this process of awakening there are different levels. The ground level is having the desire, the intention to awaken. That can only come from the ego mind. As you have likely noticed by now, the ego mind is very clever and anything but self-destructive. The urge to awaken is most unlikely to make an appearance when things are going as one wishes they would. The ego only grudgingly allows a peek at this when you have become quite frustrated with the lack of delivery on ego promises. But a full awakening would mark the death of the ego. So, what proceeds to manifest in this world of duality is opposites. On one side, the intention to awaken is a prerequisite. On the other hand, as long as you hold on to the intention to awaken, you cannot notice you already are awake. Awakeness is in the now, goals put your mind into the non-existent future. How do you make the shift from wanting to awaken to realizing awakeness? At some point the synapse is crossed, you realize you are and always have been awake. You've just been pretending to be asleep. We could call the ego mind that pretender. However, you can have the idea that you really are awake, but that is still the ego mind running things, not a true experience. So, what happens somewhere along the line, remembering that time doesn't really exist, through what I like to call the grace of God, after countless letting goes of the ego mind, is it happens. This occurrence is after intention has been released. You know in that instant that none of this really matters, that the physical is just an illusion. If that is followed by the thought that you are awake now, say hello again to your ego mind. It doesn't matter. It will likely happen. The truth is in your divinity. It cannot be hidden forever. More often you will find yourself noticing the now with no attachment, with no agenda, with no resistance, with welcomeness and gratitude.